June of 1983, the Combat Developments Experimentation Center continued the program of small, inexpensive customer tests conducted for the U.S. Army Material Systems Analysis Activity, or AMSA. The main gun accuracy against helicopter test, Mgaah, was conducted at Fort Hunter Liggett, California, by Project Team 3 to measure the ability of M60A1 tank gunners to accurately place main gun fire on helicopters flying tactical profiles. AMSA will use the test results to update their gun accuracy data used in combat models. The three primary test objectives were to provide information on the ability of M60A1 tank gunners to lead hovering helicopters, the ability of M60A1 tank gunners to lead moving helicopters, and the effect of helicopter maneuver on tank gunner aim and lead errors. Additionally, two further test objectives that illustrate the mutually beneficial nature of the customer test program were to determine the accuracy of CEDEC's real-time position measuring system and to gain data on CEDEC's ability to measure aim and lead error from bore-sighted video. To satisfy the first three objectives, helicopter position versus time had to be measured to a high degree of accuracy. To accomplish this, cinetheodolites were brought in from White Sands Missile Range, New Mexico. Through the coordinated use of 60-inch and 120-inch camera lenses and a process known as triangulation, the cinetheodolite measures the northing, easting, and height above the ground of an object. The presence of the cinetheodolites was a timely opportunity to measure the accuracy of CEDEC's real-time position measuring system in light of the fact that future missions such as the Sergeant York test and the AeroScout operational test may also require this data. Mgaah was a controlled aiming test conducted in three phases. The first phase was a training phase to introduce tank gunners to the procedures developed by CEDEC for engaging helicopters with main gun firing sabot rounds. Previously, aircraft were engaged mainly by the tank's 50 caliber machine gun, and no doctrine existed for engaging helicopters with main gun fire. The second phase was 4 days of exploratory trials, and phase three included 32 record trials conducted over a 5-day period. Each trial involved single UH-1 flights of 30 to 60 seconds in duration while being engaged by 8 M60A1 tanks. The tactical concept of the Mgaah test had the tanks placed in fixed positions. The helicopters flew 4 tactical profiles: stationary hover, evasive hover, low level, and nap of the earth, all at tactical speeds. The gunners were cued to the direction from which the target would appear in order to force engagements to the desired range band. Each simulated engagement included 2 sabot rounds, with the nominal reload time required between rounds. While the operational concept of the Mgaah test was relatively simple, the instrumented data collection methods were of a more sophisticated nature. The cinetheodolite recorded this film to document the position of the helicopter in real time. Closed circuit television recorded the approximate sight picture seen by the tank gunner. Field data collectors were wired into the tank crew CVC system to monitor the tank crew as they went through their tracking and firing procedures. In summary, the Mgaah test was a step toward the development of doctrine for engaging helicopters with the tank main gun. Further, it provided an opportunity to measure the accuracy of SEADEC's real-time position measuring system, and it was an important part of the working relationship established between SEADEC and AMSA by the customer test program.